Hello, guys. Me and Wolf says hello and good morning, because here it's morning. It's around 9 o'clock. Wolf is barking at Buddy, who is outside the door, because now, as you can see, Wolf is having his breakfast. So let's leave him alone to enjoy his breakfast and come to our model. If you remember, in our last video we placed these beautiful fenders along with the gun ports, and may I say that this way of placing the gun ports is the most ingenious way I've ever met. I have met a lot of ways. Most of the gun ports in the models that I have made are made of metal. I don't like them because it needs painting, and also lacks of detail. I don't like metal gun ports in wooden ships. The wooden gun ports are perfect. Santana had wooden gun ports, where they were beautiful. They had just a lack of a detail, needed something more. This model has it. This gun port, as you can see, is two pieces. Also, the way that you place them upon the hull with the two nails is ingenious. There's no way that you can break it unless you hit it hard. There's no way it will unglue. But in Santana, I had that problem. It was easy to unglue. But okay, leave Santana, let's go to Montans. Again, I'm saying that I have opened these two holes. I will make, I will place two ropes to simulate the ropes that they're using to lift up the gun port. But that will go after the varnishing. For now, it's not time yet to make the officer's quarters. It's time to make these rails. As you can see, we have two rows of rails, one on the outside and one on the inside. So let me get ready, place the camera on the tripod, and I'll get back to you to begin. So guys, I just took some measurements. Let me show you something that I just found, and let me tell you what I have done. If you watch carefully here, you will see that the three pieces, the three rails right here, are closer to each other, and the other ones are more apart to each other. Let's go to the drawings. Here are the drawings. As you see, they're close to each other, are the two first. All the others are in, let's say, almost an equal distance between them. So that began as a problem. What do I do? Do I follow the picture or do I follow the instructions? So what I've noticed right here is that this rail, this ladder, sorry, is at the two first, underneath the two first that are close to each other. So that makes sense. And what I decided to do is to place the two first close to each other and the next in equal distance between them. So let me move the camera a little closer. Okay, right there. So the two first, as you can see, I begin almost at the edge. I leave a small space, about 1 millimeter, just to be able to insert the rail. The first is, don't remember how much, we will see, at 1.45 millimeters, and Each and every one from the first one is at 2.1 millimeters and comes right up to the end. So I believe that's better. To the rails to the inside, it's far easier because they go exactly at the joints, so no need to take measurement there. So let me get my hand drill and see what drill tip I will use, and I'll get back to you to start. Once more, I'm going to use a drill tip of 0.8. Let's make some holes right at the center. So you get the idea. Let me do all the holes also on the inside, and I'll get back to you. As you see, guys, I have opened up holes here, here, and here also. Now, before placing the rails, this is the piece for the rails that I'm going to use, the wooden piece, because we have the metallic rails as well. And it's 1x4, it's epoly. Remember to sand it out before placing it, because after it won't be possible. So, let's begin. It's easy, nothing too hard. As you can see, the rails are already painted. No need to film that. Sorry for that, guys. So, let's place the first one. Just make sure it's vertical and everything is easy. Vertical and straight position. That's the idea. You may need to do some adjustments later from above, but as you see, it's very easy. And everything will be secured as soon as we place the wooden piece. So, nothing difficult with that. Let me do them all and I'll get back to you to place the wooden piece. So guys, as you can see, I have placed them all. Nothing hard, like I said. Now, the best way to measure this is on the rails. Let's see. We can see here at the photo that is almost touching the rail of the ship and all the way to the other side. So let's cut it over here. Let me cut it. Just a moment. Let's see now. Yeah, I like it, but I'm just going to add a touch of my own. I'm going to round up the upper part of the edges, like this. Let's do the first three, let it dry for a moment. Remember that the rails are painted, so the glue won't work as fast as it used to work, because it doesn't get that well on the paint. You see, it's not glued yet, that's because of the paint. Need some time. Okay, just a little bit boring, I should say. We have it at the two first, not at the third one. So, let's continue. Again here. Here, let's place two of the rails and see how it goes. Maybe it's better that way. All fingers on deck. I believe I have it. Beautiful. So, let's proceed. So guys, I decided to make a small change. I didn't like the sepal wood. 1x4, it was too thin and too big. It was extended a lot, much more than the rails, and it wasn't according to the photographs. I believe it was the photographs are from another model. Like I said, you can see here that here were the rails, and the rails are about 1.5 millimeter, and I had 2.5 millimeters extension. So I'm going to change it to this one, which is 3 millimeters. This is 3 millimeters, and it's also one, but this is African walnut. It will look better. So let me do that, and I'll get back to you. It looks better. Yeah, definitely better. So let's do the other ones. Again, the same way. I'm going to measure the next one. The next one must go like this. A little hard to calculate, but not impossible. Let me cut it. Let's measure again. Perfect. Some sanding. Again, rounding up the edges, the above edge on each side. perfect. And this way works better. If you place glue in all the metallic rails, it glues very fast. So, next piece. Let me see how much it extends. Just a little. Okay. This won't be hard. Let's take some measurements. Let me cut it. Also, rounding up one edge this time, not two. Because the other is going there. Exactly. Nope. Need to do something more. Glad that I saw that. I have to cut a little bit the edge, this edge, so it will fit. Let me do that. This is it. Again, some glue. Just some sanding here and we're okay. Let me do the other one, the rest of them, and I'll get back to you to show you the finishing result. I'm pretty sure that with African walnut at and 1x3, not 1x4, looks better. As you can see, they're perfect. So let me gather materials and place the camera on a tripod, because we're going to move on to make some ladders, some external ladders, and then the next step will be to make the officer's quarters over here. So let me get ready, I'll get back to you. So guys, the outside ladders will be consist from 10 steps on each side. Each step is made by two parts of 1x4 separately and 2x2 separately as a support. So let me cut them in the appropriate size and I'll get back to you. Now guys, I'm going to place the ladders. As you can see, I have a very beautiful big photograph that tells me exactly where each of these 10 steps must be. So, let me place the camera on a tripod and get started. Let's start from the bottom. The last one must go right here. As you can see, I have cut the 2mm in size and also the 1x4 in size and rounded up at the edges. So, this is where it should go. Let's glue. This piece is 8mm long, and the upper piece is 10. So it's very easy to make them centered. First step in place. Now, as you can see, I have to place another step over here. So, here I will start in the reverse order. First, the 10 mm. And underneath the 8, sorry. According to the photograph, I must place two more. I don't believe that the width here is enough for two more. If I place here, let me check that and I'll get back to you. And done, guys. If you count the steps, you will see that there are not 10, then 11. Let me explain why I placed 11 steps. If you see here at the photo, the black line underneath the rail, it's much smaller than it is here. Like I said in the photo, I'm pretty sure that it's a previous version of this model. So over here at the photo, there is just one step. If I use just one step over here, there will be a big gap underneath. Because as you can see here, the gaps are almost even. But here, I had to place two steps. Or else, I had a big gap, and probably the people that were going to go up and down the stairs will do some acrobatics here. So, 11 steps for this side, also 11 for the other side. I haven't done the other side yet. I will do it in a moment. Nothing hard. So, this concludes our video for today, guys. Rails and outside ladders. I believe that Montans is looking even better, but the finishing touch before the varnish, of course, is the office quarters that I'm going to make in the next video. So, guys, me and Wolf. Wolf, say bye-bye to everybody. Wolf! Probably wants to eat everybody, not say bye-bye. Outside his body, as you can see, he loves him. Look how he has eaten again the paint from the door. That's a 2 weeks paint job. So, me, Wolf and Montans say goodbye to you, and we'll meet again in our next video.